Who is it?
I killed him, Diane. I killed him, and it doesn't mean a damn thing. What do I do now?
Come on, Eric. Let's go. Let's get out of here.
Help me. You saw what happened. Please. Look, you've got to lock me up someplace and then get the hell out of here. Please. Now lock the door and make sure I can't get out.
I'll make sure of that. And Eric, you were right, you know. Giannis was not the father of us all.
Find him at the old Bijou Theater.
The Indian is on his way.
One down. One to go.
Do you really think Rogan can handle Cord?
That man has tenacity. A true javelin.
He's hunted our young wolf across the continent. Still, when this is over,
perhaps we should consider helping Mr. Rogan with his own nightmare.
I don't understand you. Why have you just kept on running? Doesn't make sense.
I know it doesn't to you. Sometimes it hasn't even made sense to me.
What's it like when it comes over you? Would you know your own mother? If your parents were still alive, could you spare them?
I'd like to think so.
Come on, let me talk to you, Rogan. Consider my problems, Rogan. I got me a nutball. Maybe it's your boy Cord. But now I got this clown with a busted neck down cellar and this stiff here who looks like he was used as a target for the javelin throw. Does your boy vary his ammo? Come on, talk to me, Rogan. I never knew me an axe murderer who said, oh, okay, well, it's Tuesday. I guess I'll use a spear today. Your boy some kind of switch hitter?
No, Delaney, he always kills the same.
Well, up until a couple of hours ago, that bastard with the one eye was my ace, number one bad guy for these killings that have been taking place in the quarter. Do you know who he was?
Tell me something. You always use silver bullets.
I do now. I thought I did. I thought he was some kind of fisherman.
Who killed him?
Cord. He told me he was looking for something, but I didn't believe him. I was wrong.
I suppose now you're gonna ask me about the silver, the bullet you found in the church, the spear you found here.
I was.
I've been tracking Cord all across the country. Mostly he zigs around, like a fly that got in a cider. Then all of a sudden, he takes off in a straight line for here. He came to hunt someone. And I think he found him. But it wasn't the answer to the questions he was looking for. Now, I think he's after the rest of it.
Son.
Do you hear me, Father?
I hear you, son.
Forgive me, O Lord. I have sinned against thee grievously. Forgive me.
The crimes this unfortunate has admitted to are real. Destroying the sanctity of the grave and the eating of human flesh. However, it is my opinion that they were committed out of degeneracy and not lycanthropy. Therefore, in the name of the Lord of us all, I pronounce sentence
death.
Woo! They strangled his sister Tandy, and they could not have made Tandika. His sister Petraja Musica, they zingarella silari. Tom for the Pascal Lele track, and they guitar a forcenea. Francais who then an obstinea, ma me chanson, ma me.
A wolf drawn by blood. The Nazis. One of my few mistakes. Doesn't you like such children? What can I say except that for 12 years Europe was a brothel of death and blood. It overwhelmed the senses. You'd know what I mean by that, wouldn't you, Eric?
She was practiced at the art of deception. I could tell by her blood-stained hands. Isn't that how the song goes?
What did you sell your soul for? How much was it worth? How do you like your eternal life now, Diane?
I like it just fine. As for your hellfire and brimstone, you can keep it to yourself.
You think you know something about hell, Eric? You think hell is no more than the destiny of a soul that failed? Let me teach you about hell.
The silver burns, doesn't it?
You see how it is, Eric. For you tonight, there is only three choices. The classic three of our kind. Death by silver. Death by execution. Or by your own hand. I am relishing this. To finally put an end to that wretched Scorzini and the miserable line he sired. I granted him power, ultimate power, and he ran amok, granting it helter-skelter. I suppose I should feel gratitude to you for
saving me the trouble of hunting down the last of Scorzini's bastards.
Well, if you felt that way about him, why did you keep him around so long?
Scorzini was diseased. It was a degenerative disease eating him from the inside out, killing him. Still, he had his uses. He was my pawn, like Diane.
Are you listening to this, Diane? Are you taking notes? Wasn't that a sweet eulogy for his old buddy? A few hundred years from now, what's he going to be saying about you? Maybe then you won't care. Maybe then you'll be a rotting hulk like the late unlamented Scorzini. How many others, Remy? How many pawns have there been? How far back do you go?
What do you want me to say? Do you want me to take responsibility for all the troubles of this silly little race? Do you think it was I that slew Abel? You poor, puny thing. In your own way, you disgust me as much as Janos did. I spent 15 years building this identity, the colorful young professor of economics. One entrance line away from the State House. I haven't been this close to real power since 1914. When Scorzini comes running along to me, trailing blood and a rabid young wolf and an Indian with silver bullets. When I saw Janos kneeling there in his humiliation. I've learned over the years that sometimes you have to let the moment go. Time for your release. Could have offered you even the faintest glimmer of hope.
In ancient times, the Vikings believed if a man dreamed of wolves, the enemy was about to attack. Scorzini dreamed of wolves, and there you were, Eric. What about you, my friend? Did you dream of wolves?
Damn silver.
Makes you wonder, doesn't it?
No, it doesn't. Not unless your boy's gotten off axes and is now into matches. I got me a Jane Doe body. I got me a big mother fire. I got me a missing professor who was about to be christened by the governor. I also got me a nice, nasty explanation. Sex. Well, I don't see your boy's fine Italian hand in all this.
The girl's a photographer named Diane Bathory. She was seen with Eric Cord, and she's good friends with the missing Remy.
No, it's still sex.
All I do know is Cord's on the run again, and he's searching for something. But what it is, I don't know.
Let it go, Rogan. Guys like us, we get a hold of the wrong questions, and all we get is old.
You don't understand, Delaney. It's not what I've got a hold of. It's what's got a hold of me.
Thank you.
Keep your eye on the little lady. Whoa, eat your heart out, Annie Oakley. Oh, this isn't Monte Carlo, lady, but you just broke the bank.
What did I win?
Well, either a box of imitation Havanas or the biggest panda since Nixon went to China.
I'll work on the cigars next time. Whoa! It's just like the one I had when I was a little girl.
You're blind.
As old man Pugh.
Well, how'd you do it?
The ears have it.
I can't leave you alone for a minute. Turn my back and you're flirting with the help.
I did it, Austin.
What did you do?
Last time all I got was to go fish in a bowl. I hated it. I kept thinking it was making faces at me in the bowl.
Are you ready for the biggie now? Huh? Shall we dare the behemoth that is the roller coaster?
Oh.
What do you say? You're on a roll.
Not just yet, Austin, please.
Okay. Hey. You want $20?
Are you kidding?
I have a two-seater car. And with the bear, that makes three of us. She lives at
507 Mead Avenue.
You got any problems with that?
No, sir, boss. Us help Ames to please.
You ready?
Yep.
Okay. Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
So, you got a date for tonight, or did you come with somebody?
Well, you wait right here for your new mom.
Hello? Is there somebody short there?
Nope. Only the guy with the bear.
Let's put it inside. I'll figure out where her new home is when I get back.
Okay. I can give you a lift.
Oh, no, thanks. I can take the bus. I'm going to my fiancé's apartment. I'm planning a little surprise for tonight.
Oh, no, really. I counted the boss into giving me the truck for a couple hours. There'd be no trouble at all.
Well, all right.
Okay, great.
And Austin had me sign up for some cooking classes for the blind. Tonight's my own private final exam. Austin's always surprising me. So I decided turnabout's fair play. Wine, dinner, romance, the whole bit. Tell me something, Eric. Is candlelight as romantic as they say?
Sylvia, speaking of light, I could use a little myself.
Oops, it's right behind you. Well, what do you think of Austin as an interior decorator?
Well, he must have put a lot of thought into the place.
He did. Austin thinks it's worthwhile to buy handmade, even if it does cost a ton. I play a little game with myself. Whenever I walk into a room, you can tell a lot about a person by what you find. Fine art, a computer, technically minded, but creative as well. He's even taking a class in Braille right now, so he can see what I have to go through. Knickknacks. It's a model of a roller coaster car. This is a little boy in him. I'm sorry, going on about Austin like a schoolgirl. I must be boring you to tears. But you're so easy to talk to.
Well, thanks. But you're not boring me at all.
Well, friends of mine, they moan a lot about how hard it is to find a decent man. It isn't any easier when you're blind. Austin's only the second boyfriend I've had in my entire life. The first boyfriend I had was a professor in college.
Well, it's hard to trust anybody when something like that happens.
Austin spent a lot of time helping me get over that. I can take a bus across town now, cook, meet people, shoot a gun, even ride a horse. Well, almost. That was a failed encounter group. I first encountered the horse, and then I encountered the ground. Austin says it's a real good photo of me in the air, screaming a lot. Bet you didn't recognize me upside down.
Nope. Didn't recognize you at all.
Honey, did you clean the house today?
No. Why?
Nothing.
Honey, is something wrong? Was dinner a bust?
No, honey. I'm sorry. It's just this stupid meeting tonight. Not only does this jerk think that you know something about computers, he's ruined your little surprise party.
I can stay here till you get back.
I'm not fit company now. And I won't be when this imbecile meeting is over with tonight. I'll just go down to my office, get my notes, put my race face on, and try to convince this yo-yo that he needs Cathcart images more than he needs a brain transplant.
Oh, honey, you'll do just fine. Got your good duds on?
Nope. Drop you at home?
No way. The least I could do is pull KP and find my own bus. Member independence.
Right. Sorry. I'll call you tomorrow.
Wait a minute, Buster. We ain't married yet. I want my kiss.
I'm sorry, honey.
Goodbye. I'm Janet. Our specials tonight are triple strawberry daiquiri or double jelly beans. Oh, I get you. You're thinking a beer and a shot, right?
Well, what I was thinking is kind of embarrassing. I mean, when I first walked in here and saw you, I've been running every line I know through my head. All I've got is time to get off.
2 a.m. But see, that's still no good. Me and the relief bartender are known as an item. We leave together. Nice try, honey. So, what will it be?
Nothing. Now I'm too depressed to drink.
Hello, this is Sylvia.
Hi, honey. Look,
I was really stupid at dinner tonight, and I just wanted to call and say how sorry I was. Everything was great.
Thanks, but you should have stuck around for dessert.
Tell me the truth. Now, you didn't haul all that stuff up there by yourself, did you?
Well, actually, I got a ride home with someone. But the dinner was mine. No outside help.
Who's the someone?
Eric Cord. The man you paid to bring my prize home from the fair.
Oh, that's someone. Listen, I've got to run. I'll talk to you later.
Baby, the concert's laying up. We're going to get swamped.
You know what? I got an emergency. Just cover for me with the boss, right?
Honey, you're going to get fired.
Just cover for me. It all broke loose. I'll tell you about it tomorrow, okay?
Well, whatever's going on, you don't want to look like you've been playing patty cake in the park.
Sylvia, look, when I first saw Austin's place, I only thought he was a phony. But then I found out the rest.
If you don't get out of here, I'm calling the cops.
Then give me 2 minutes first. I've got it all right here, but you just can't see it. You can't see the stolen credit cards or the certificate from the Braille Institute. God, that's his whole bit. Don't you get it? His M.O. Sylvia... he cozies up to blind women, marries them, and then kills them for the insurance. $350,000, double indemnity, your name on it. How can I convince you? Do you have any close friends? Do you have a doctor? Okay, fine. Take all this stuff to him then in the morning. Look, let him tell you what's here. Then you'll see. Sylvia, there's nothing in this for me. Look, I'm out of here. Call the cops if you want, but please take this stuff to the doctor in the morning because I don't want to see you end up like another newspaper headline. Look, if that's Austin, I'll be in the kitchen, right, if you need any help.
Hello?
Ms. Nelson?
Yes?
I'm Officer Morgan. Looking for a man by the name of Eric Cord. He's working at Ocean View Park up until this morning. He's wanted for murder in Los Angeles.
Are you sure that's all you told the cops about him? I dropped off the panda, that's it?
It was probably wrong, but yes. I was too humiliated, made a fool of
by a wanted killer. He probably conned some poor old cripple, then shot her when things went wrong. He's filth, absolute filth.
But he had stuff from your apartment.
Well, sure he did. I mean, what's a little burglary to a murderer? Honey, of course you were taken in. I mean, we both know that you're still a little rocky emotionally. Besides... credit card. Of course it doesn't have my name on it. It belongs to poor Owen Locke. He got fried over at my place last week and lost his wallet.
I shouldn't have.
This thing he calls an insurance policy. It's the prenuptial agreement that we had drawn up last month. This guy is sick. I mean, using something like this. I hope he tries something when the cops do catch him. So we're going to put an end to this right now. I am not going to let anything, no matter how trivial, come between us.
It's a model of a roller coaster car. This is a little boy in him.
Is it all settled?
And you still love me?
Woman, what do you want me to do? Get back down on my knees and propose?
Oh, Austin. It should be the other way around. I should prove myself to you.
No, no. Proof is not what it's all about. It's about confidence. Confidence in the world. Confidence in me. Confidence in yourself. You've come a long way since we first met, honey. And you have beaten almost every challenge.
Except the roller coaster.
Oh,
come on. Ready?
No, but it's never going to get any easier. Okay, girl. Get yourself together. Blouse button. Lipstick straight. And, got a hanky.
Yeah.
Wow!
What?
Perfume! This belongs to some woman!
You're saying it belongs to me!
Right! Since when did you start wearing $2 a gallon Bobsy perfume?
Wait, I remember. See, I had a little accident.
Don't insult me with something quick and cheap! Think a little harder than that, you bastard!
Any better.
worry about a thing, ma'am. We haven't lost a passenger yet.
The den! The den! Safe from Silverman!
Eat, wolf brother. Still hungry, wolf brother? Old meat. We hunt together tonight. Fresh. Many years since hunted with pack brothers. Me was Zora Pack when great ice came. Before, all gone now. Soft men with hard silver. You Zora Pack?
No. What are you...
Blackfoot. Black Wolf. Mather.
Werewolf lines? Packs?
Palocci. Mendez. Kadar. Know them all. Know yours, too. Howard. Scorzini. Not Scorzini.
You knew Scorzini?
Bad wolf. Kill pack brothers. You Scorzini wolf?
Bad. Bad is right. I killed the bastard. For all the good it did.
You kill Scorzini? Take very strong wolf for kill that one. Maybe strong enough. Maybe together we strong enough to kill wolf that make me like soft man's dog. Stronger than Scorzini. Worst wolf of all.
Worst of all?
Remy.
Let me teach you about hell.
How are you? We got parts for any car you can think of. What'll it be? I mean to fit your name on it.
Just a little friendly conversation. I brought my own lubrication.
Well, my daddy would have appreciated this. Before he went on the wagon, that is. Okay. Name your poison.
I'm looking for a man.
And I'm looking for a woman.
He's a pretty bad boy. Crazed killer. Tracked him here last night, then I lost him. I'm pretty sure he's hiding out in your junkyard. I'd like to hang around till he decides to show himself, however long it takes. Won't be no bother. And you get to keep the bottle. We got a deal.
Cops don't come around with no bottle. You ain't some kind of reporter?
Reporter?
Doing a story on the old monster?
Monster.
Daddy's dog that walks like a man. Don't tell me.
Do tell. No, I'm after the bounty. I'm no reporter. But, I do have a soft spot for a tall tale.
Well, this one's sure worth a good bottle of sour mash.
Matter of fact, it was enough to make Daddy leave the yard to me, retire to Florida, and go on the wagon. And if you knew how Daddy liked his whiskey, you'd know that took some doing. Anyway, this was a rough neighborhood, even back when Daddy's daddy owned the yard. Knifings and beatings and your dead bodies and all. Now, Daddy, he was a tough old boy, especially when he was drunk as a skunk, which he was that night as usual. Anyway, that explains why he didn't just turn tail and run when he saw what he said he saw. He staggered home when he hears these growls coming from this vacant lot. And Daddy being Daddy has to have himself a look-see. Oh. Now what he saw, or what he swears he saw,
is a giant dog standing like a man, and some wino on all fours like he was the hound and the dog was his master. And the giant dog has just killed somebody. And the dog backs a man off the kill like an old hound dog. And Daddy, being Daddy, tracks a sucker halfway across town to Hill Street. Pretty scary, huh, bounty hunter?
Well?
Well, that's when the story stops being scary and gets plain stupid. Daddy tracks this dog all the way to the grounds of the lion's den. He babbles to the cops, a couple of squad cars show up. And after Nicholas Gage gets through chewing him out for bothering him, the cops beat the crap out of Daddy and throw him in the drunk tank.
Is that right?
Right. Guess you don't know this town too well, huh, Mr. Bounty Hunter? The Lion's Den is this fancy private business club. The only dog on the grounds is this beagle, too old to tree a coon. Mr. Gage is mighty well connected. He don't exactly appreciate the cops busting in at all. And you better believe the cops don't exactly appreciate Daddy's tall tale, neither.
And the body?
Oh, they found a stiff, all right. Some old wino had his head stove in with a pipe. Not a tooth mark on him. So, there's your bottle's worth of tall tale, Mr. Bounty Hunter. You can hang around here all you like. As long as you don't scare the paying customers. Hope you do better than Daddy did. Leastways, take my advice. Do your monster hunting sober.
Remy has power when he wants. Hunt red coat men with him. Hunt Indian. He teaches me be strong like himself. He promises. But Remy, bad wolf. Remy lie. He makes me hunt without the power. He makes me hunt like dog. Run on 4 feet. Then takes my kills himself, throws me old bones, sometimes nothing.
Redcoats? Indians? How long ago was this?
Many seasons. Redcoat men. Indians. Big hat men in wagons. Hunts off men like Remy's dog. Long after ice melt, long after Zora pack gone. I think Remy good new pack leader. But he makes me like dog. Long time, I think. Then railroad come. Remy goes away. I run to woods. He never find me.
This happened many years ago. You never saw him again?
Hide in woods many seasons. Men with guns come, build fort, town, city. They're safe. Forget Wolf. I learn from Remy. Best den hidden where soft prey live. It's true. It's easy. I learn to kill without the power. Soft, weak, like many sick deer. This is enough for them. Hunt all the time. It's enough. Tonight, I teach. Together, we hunt like pack brother. No need see Remy.
Remy? But I thought you... Is he here? Is he here now?
Comes back. Comes back. New den. But still, make me hunt for him.
Makes you hunt like a dog.
Dog? Yes. Wish could kill Remy. But too strong.
We can kill Remy. You and me.
You strong wolf. You kill Scorsini.
I kill Scorsini. Tonight, we can kill Remy.
Tonight, we kill Remy. Pack brother.
Persistent.
Soft, weak, like blind owl in daylight.
I don't know, Pat, brother. You don't know Rogan.
Comes to he who sits and waits.
Kill together now, then be pack brothers.
Kill Remy.
Must track Remy.
But you know where he is.
Hunt now. Find prey. Get blooded.
What?
I teach. You follow.
Hey, what the hell are you doing? This is the second time we've been on this street. Are you taking me in circles?
No, we hunt. Have scent now. Soft ones. Kill is easy.
Wait a minute. What are you talking about? We hunt Remy. He makes you into a dog, remember?
Remy? Must kill. I lead, you follow. We kill together. Become pack brothers.
Wait a minute. We kill Remy.
Hunt now.
Doing here? We're not gonna find Nicholas Remy hanging out on the street like this. I said, what the hell are we doing?
Hunt, soft ones, kill together.
Wait a minute. It's Remy we're supposed to be hunting, remember?
You say, you strong wolf, kill Scorsini. Must prove you good pack brother. Must share blood together before we hunt Remy. Maybe you lie. Maybe you weak.
Weak? Weak? You're the weak one. You always crawled for Remy. Did you want to be his dog?
You talk like soft one. Words. no words for Strong Wolf.
Who's there?
Kill him. Or I kill you. Kill. 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 Kill.
Who's out there?
What's going on? No!
Remy! Remy! Where is he? I'll find him and kill him for you, I promise.
Dan.
Remy! Damn it, where's Remy?
Strong.
What's that? Where's he heading?
Den.
Den? What den?
Strong Wolf. Lion. Den.
You have the look of a desperate man, Mr. Rogan.
That pretty well describes things, Mr. Gage, but skinny as it is, it's the only lead I've got.
Respectable-looking young man. Why, may I ask, is he wanted?
Murder.
Well, our members have their eccentricities, but so far, murder is not among them. I'm afraid I've never seen your Cord. He certainly isn't a member nor an employee.
Thanks, I'm not surprised. Cord prefers other kinds of dens. Good day.
Rest assured, if I come across Cord, I'll take the appropriate actions.
At 8:17 p.m., I was feeding a stray cat on the corner of Rose and Temple. The cat's name is Cersei. At that time, I observed suspicious lights and sounds coming from the southeast corner of the intersection. Upon investigating, I saw what appeared to be a flying saucer. A Venusian flying saucer.
How do you know it was Venusian? Sorry.
Upon sighting the alleged saucer, I immediately...
Mother!
Thank you for looking after my mother, Sergeant Eisenberg. I know what a bother she's been.
Bother? Grace, she's one of our favorite people.
I'm sorry, Grace, but we got orders. We had to call her. Why don't you just give me your notebook, and I could finish that up later.
Mother. Bye, Grace.
Bye, Karen.
See you tomorrow.
Don't despair, young man. I know things look terrible now, but remember, there are others worse off.
My mom used to say that.
You know, that bread is not going to fill you up. What you need is a good meal inside you. It'll change your whole outlook on life.
I'll be sure to do that. Oh. Nice meeting you.
No. Well, you don't have any money, do you? Here, take this. And when you're back on top, do the same for someone else. I can tell things are going to change for you very shortly.
Thanks, ma'am. Excuse me.
Oh, there's a vegetarian restaurant right down the street that has all-you-can-eat specials. Don't forget to order the spicy cheese sauce.
Right.
Oh, it's nice to see young people with an appetite.
Yo, hold up, Holmes.
Your money, punk. Give it up.
Here, man. $2, all right? It's all I got. Take it.
$2!
Hey!
Man, I cannot believe people today. Don't they understand $2 just makes you mad?
You leave that young man alone. Leave him alone.
What the hell?
You No.
mind tied to your behind? You forget to check the batteries on your handy-talkie?
No, I wasn't responding.
I hope you weren't visiting one of your new girlfriends, Armis, because I am not in the mood today. I got people swinging lead all over the place.
I thought I might find something that would help Grace.
You were looking for a werewolf? Give me a break.
Oh, I figured it was a big damn dog or something. How's Grace doing, anyway?
Your daughter finally went and done it. Had her committed.
Grace in a loony bin? It'll kill her.
Before I got on the force, I was a social worker for a couple of years. Met a lot of people like Grace. First it puts you off, then you figure it out. They're like everybody else. We're all walking around with our delusions. Take me and you. You think you're the universal foot cop, and me, I'm gonna make chief. The point is, we're not hurting anybody, and neither was Grace.
Pity there isn't a real werewolf. I'd lead him up to Margaret Benson's front door, have him do a little open-heart surgery.
He might have trouble finding it.
The only reason I agreed to see you, Mr. Court, is that you're a friend of my mother's. And I owe her that. And, quite frankly, unlike most of her friends, you seem to be employed. You're a lot cleaner cut. Although I can't say much for your taste in shoes.
Well, I'm sorry. These are my second pair. The others are being fixed. Look, let's get right to the point. I talked to a lot of people in your mom's neighborhood. I mean, they all think she's a pretty amazing woman. There isn't anyone on the block that doesn't owe her, feel responsible for her. And we'd all just like to help.
Well, that's very nice. I'm sure she'd enjoy visitors, so if you'll give me their names, I'll make sure they get on the list.
Well, that's not exactly what I meant. You see, we think this thing's gotten blown way out of proportion.
Oh, you want me to relent and let her out of the home, is that it?
Well, yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's all pretty harmless, isn't it?
Mr. Cord, this time she almost got herself killed. Now, I offered her a lovely home here with us, and she refused me. She keeps threatening to go live with my aunt in Montana, and she's just as bad as my mother. I don't like doing this, Mr. Cord, but my mother is sick, mentally ill, and I'm seeing to it that she finally gets the help that she needs.
Come on. It's not that bad, is it?
Not that bad? I'd like to know your definition of insane, Mr. Cord. I mean, first it was aliens from outer space. Then it was mole people from the center of the earth. And now it's a werewolf. A werewolf. Now, I call that insane. Wouldn't you, Mr. Cord? Wouldn't you, Mr. Cord?
I saw Mark Twain was in Natchez. We had the most marvelous dinner, and it was time for our aperitif.
Yes, Mrs. Barry. Your daughter's doing much better now. Well, we had our little problems at first. Unauthorized phone calls, reading material, that sort of thing. But she finally came around. Fits in quite nicely now.
These look like worm pills. What's in these, young man?
Just what Dr. Galen prescribed. Now, knock them back.
Not until I know what's in them.
Would you hold for a moment, Mrs. Barry?
No, Grace, dear. You know you have to take your medicine every afternoon at 3. Now be a good girl and take your pills.
Don't call me dear and don't call me Grace, you diploma mill pill peddler. My name is Mrs. Sullivan.
Very well, Mrs. Sullivan. You can either take your pills voluntarily or by injection.
yuck, what is this? Mr. Canfield, how do they get away with this?
Well, stealing again.
I don't steal. I trade.
As I was saying, it is, of course, a plot, my dear Mrs. Sullivan. Diamond Jim Brady and a certain scoundrel who purports to be my son are in cahoots. While I languish here in durance vile, they are conspiring to take over my Saratoga gambling palace unless I can free myself in time.
No, not that plot, Mr. Canfield. This one here. Oh,
you mean the good Dr. Galen? Well, it's very simple. He and his lackey arranged to have certain harmless eccentrics put in their charge. Eccentrics with well-to-do, if dunder-brained relatives to foot the bill. Then they extract the maximum in money while providing the minimum in services. Unlike a gambling hall, as I've come to see.
I wish I were in Montana. Huh? I wish we were all in Montana.
We're not eating our dinners.
I'm watching my weight.
Your weight is our business, Mrs. Sullivan, not yours. Actually, we'd like to fatten you up a little.
Not with this glop buster.
Now you stay in here until the doctor says you can come out.
Oh, you sit on it, Neil. Pardon. I'm here because of some regrettable delusions I've been suffering from.
Delusions?
Yes. Due to the wonderful treatment I'm getting, I've come to realize there are no such things as aliens, mole people, flying saucers, or werewolves.
So I bet you're pretty scared, huh? This joint's enough to scare the hell out of anybody. But I don't think it'll work. Listen, Galen's gonna keep you here until your daughter runs out of money.
But what can I do?
Well, first we have to separate fantasy from reality. And you never saw a flying saucer, did you, Grace? Or mole people, or aliens. But you did see a werewolf. I know. I am one. No. Don't be scared. Don't be scared. I'm not going to hurt you. Listen, I called your sister Doris on the phone today. She's wiring money. I got a plan. We're going out of here this weekend.
But what about my friends?
What the hell are you doing in here, Cord? Outside. Employee. Now you stay on the brooms and out of the rooms. You got me.
Loud and clear. There's nothing to worry about, Mrs. Benson. Electrotherapy is routine treatment. Grace will be an entirely new woman. I realize you're upset, but you'll see, this is the most caring thing you could do for your mother. Very good. I'll send Neil over with the proper forms, and we can schedule Grace for treatment immediately. Very well.
Okay. Nobody panic. I've got a duplicate key made. Grace still goes out, but she goes out tonight. Now, this is how it works. I'm going to swap the doc's tranquilizers for sugar pills.
But don't let on, okay? Everybody get in your rooms, and for God's sakes, please keep it quiet. No matter what happens, Grace and I are going to go out the side door because Neil never checks it.
But what about my friends here?
I wish there was some way I could help all of you to shut this place down, but I don't know what I can do.
What about these rooms? The state ordered people to freak if they saw those.
I know just the guy who'd be interested. Okay, that's it. Just don't mess me up.
Why, Eric!
Well?
What are you doing? We can't take all these people with us.
What the holy hell is going on here? Neil, take Grace, pardon, Mrs. Sullivan, to the treatment room. She can spend the night there tonight.
Oh, sit on it, Galen.
Make sure she can't injure herself or the equipment.
Hey!
You have a problem with your temper cord.
See what happens in wannabe heroes cord. Rescues only happen in the movies.
I've had enough of this nonsense.
All right, all right. Thinking of some kind of thing.
No. 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 Oh. Oh.
Montana.
Positive.
Mrs. Sullivan, my dear, what are the social ethics of gambling in your sister's state?
Well, Doris says if they find more than six aces in the deck, they shoot you.
Well, now that might cramp my style.
Oh, well, this is going to be wonderful. We're going to be clean. We're going to be rich. Doris has promised me that the Martians have promised to take us to their base on the moon. Here we are. Hurry along. Right that way, the train, you'll find it over there. Here we go. That's it.